कृतारि वञ्चने दृष्टिः येनाञ्जनमलीमसा अच्युताय नमस्तस्मै परमौचित्यकारिणे. वि लुक्ड् एट् पद औचित्यं लास्ट् क्लास् वेर् हि सेड् द डेफिनेशन् आफ् पद औचित्यम् इस् तिलकम् इट् इस् नाट् एक्चुलि द डेफिनेशन् दट् हि सेस् हि ओन्ली टाक्स् अबौट् हौ दि औचित्यं काण्ट्रिब्यूट्स् टु द ब्यूटि आफ् द काव्यम् विच् इस् वेन् हि सेड् तिलक तिलकं बिभ्रति सूक्तिः भाति एकम् उचितं पदं चन्द्रानने चन्द्रानना इव कस्तूरीकृतं श्यामा इव चन्दनम् इट् इट् एड्स् ब्यूटि टु द काव्यम् ईवन् वन् वर्ड् केन् एड् ब्यूटि टु द काव्यं जस्ट् लैक् हौ अ तिलकम् on the face of whether it is a fair lady or a dark complexioned lady, it depends on the type of tilakam that she is having and it adds beauty to the face as such. So that's how even a padam can be a contributor to the beauty. Okay, and now it goes to the pada auchityasya udaharanam. We saw this also. Magnani dvishatam kulani samare tvatkatka dharakule natha asminiti vandivachi bahushaha deva shrutayampura mugdha gurjara bhumipala mahishi प्रत्याशया पाथसः कान्तारे चकिता विमुञ्चति मुहुः पत्युः कृपाणे दृशौ. अ वेरी इन्नसेंट लेडी कीप्स ऑन लुकिंग एट हर हस्बैंड्स सोर्ड बिकॉज शी हैज हर्ड सो मेनी टाइम्स द वर्ड खड्ग दारा एंड द्विषतां कुलानि मग्नानि. The enemy, host of enemies have all been drowned in the sword, in the flow of the sword. Whereas it actually means he swept his sword in such a manner that he just killed so many of the Shatrus. But this Mugdha word indicates and gives a meaning to the entire shlokam as such. And without that word Mugdha, if I say Tanvi Gurjara Bhumi Pala Mahishi, it's not going to explain why she even understood the Dhara, Khadga Dhara, to be a Jala Dhara. And Magnani to be not Nashita, Nashtani, and she thought it is Magnani. It is only because of that Mugdhatva. She is so innocent, or she is such a she's a person who doesn't understand the meaning properly. Okay. He gives another shlokam. No, this is anauchityam, right? The other shlokam is for vakya dosham, that he gives two words there, two shlokas there. We'll go to that. Now here padagata anauchityasya udaharanam, where the padam is not does not reveal any specific beauty to the shloka. Lavanya dravina vyayona ganitaha klesho mahan swikritaha स्वच्छन्दस्य सुखं जनस्य वसतः चिन्ताज्वरौ निर्मितः एषापि स्वयमेव तुल्यरमणाभावात् वराकी हता को अर्थः चेतसि वेधसा विनिहितः तन्व्याः तनुं तन्वता तन्व्याः तनुं तन्वता वेधसा चेतसि कः अर्थः विनिहितः. A lady, he is Brahma has created the form of a girl. How is that girl? Tanvyaha tanum tanvata. Tanvi is actually a word that you use for the lady who is tanu or krishangi. Krishangi is one who has very what to say, not thin but more of you're not able to see the slides. Okay. Tanvyaha तन्व्याः तनुं तन्वता सृष्टवता वेधसा ब्रह्मणा कः अर्थः मनसि निधाय कृतम्. ऐ डोण्ट् नो वाट् हि हेड् इन् हिस् मैण्ड् वेन् हि क्रियेटेड् दिस् बाडि आफ् हर् हू डजन्ट् हेव् एनी यु नो नायक. The idea of the entire shloka is he talks about the great effort that Brahma has put in creating such a beautiful form, but she does not have anybody to enjoy that form with. The beauty has to be enjoyed with someone else, like a nayaka. So lavanya dravina vyayaha na ganitaha, he did not think about the expenditure of the samagri, lavanya samagri that he had. Okay, Lavanya Dravina, Lavanyam beauty, Dravina is the wealth of beauty that he had with him. Tatra Lavanya Dravinasya Vyayaha Naganitaha. He spent so much of effort in using all the Lavanya Samagri. That is, let's say when Brahma wanted to create this body, he had a set of things that would help him in creating, face and eyes and all that. So beauty elements that are needed to create the body. So he used spent so much of those ingredients to create this body. Lavanya, Dravina, Vyayaha, Na Ganitaha. He did not think of that expense there. Mahana Kleshaha Svikritaha. He undertook a great task here, which only gave him Kleshaha, Dukkham. Right? Mahan Kleshaha Dukkham Tan Nirmane Mahan Kleshaha Svikritaha. In order to create that body. Next, Swachandasya Sukham Vasataha Janasya Chintajvaraha Nirmitaha. He also created anybody who looks at such a beautiful person will always keep on thinking in his mind, oh, she's so beautiful, what do? I am not able to attain her. All sorts of thoughts will go on in the person who keeps on thinking about her. Right? So, Swachandasya Swatantrena Yaha Vasati Saha Sukham Vasataha. Without any problem, someone is just without any thoughts in his mind, he is living very happily. But for even for that person who lives with freedom and with happiness, for that person, Tasya Janasya Chinta Jwaraha Nirmitaha. Chinta Jwaraha means it's a rogam, like chinta, like a depression. You keep on thinking about how this girl is, and he keeps on, worrying about this person. So that chinta has also been created by Brahma. When the man who looks at this girl will also feel that thought process in his mind. So he has created that also. He not only created this body, he used up all of his saundarya dravinam, saundarya wealth, sampat that he has. He undertook a great task by doing this and experienced dukkha by creating this body. He also, not only he experienced dukkham, he also put in dukkham to the people who are viewing this woman. Now, how is this woman? Esha api swayameva tulya ramana abhavat varaki hata. Swayameva hata. She gets destroyed just by herself because she is Varaki. She is in a very pitiable state. Why? Tulya Ramana Abhavat. There is none equal to her. In praising her, he actually says there are people who look at her with Virahavastha. Huh? Also, it's not she who is like that, right? And Tulya Ramana Abhavat, for want of Ramana, a Nayaka who is Tulya, who is equal to her in all aspects, it is not there for her. So Tulya Ramana Abhavat, Esha Api, this girl, Varaki, poor girl, Swayameva Hata. She, as a single, her life is gone now because she doesn't have anybody equal to her. So what did Brahma think about when he created this body? It's a nice shloka. It's a very beautiful shloka. Unless Kshemendra points out the anauchityam for us, we will never know what the anauchitya here is. Okay? He uses the word tanvi here. So the vritti here that goes here is atra tanvyaha iti padam kevala shabda anuprasa vyasanitaya nibaddham. It is only used, nibaddham, it has been used in the shloka only as an exercise, as an abhyasa for shabdanuprasa. What is shabdanuprasa? Where there is a repetition of a group of letters, a consonant, a group of vowel and consonant is repeated. Here, tanvyaha, tanum, tanvata. He wanted to get that alliteration in place. The poet, Rajashekara, has written this poetry, and just for that alliteration, he has used the word tanvyaha, tanum tanvata. when we are talking about the beauty of the girl, if you talk about how thin she is, then it will not evoke that Vipralamba Shringara, it will not evoke a Shringara in the reader. Tanvi should be used only at places where Vipralamba Shringara is used. In the sense, when the girl is separated from her husband or separated from the Nayaka and she is suffering, then her limbs are all emancipated or just very, very thin, right? Emaciated. Very thin. So that is when you have to use the word Tanvi to show Tanvi Shyama Shikhari Dashana Pako Bimbada Roshti. When Yaksha in Megha Sandesha, he describes the Yakshi to the Megham. He says, you will find her, my lover, Naika, my wife, she will be Tanvi Shyama Shikhari Dashana Pako Bimbada Roshti. There he uses the word Tanvi to indicate that she will be in virahavastha. She will be separated from me, so she, all her limbs will be very thin. Krishangi, Tanvi, Shyama. But even then, she will be beautiful. Shikhari Dashana, Pakva Bimbada Roshti. Every other anga, you will find the beauty in her. Even though she is thin, she will be beautiful. I think in Shakuntalam also, he says that. So it is important that the word Tanvi is used in places where Vipralamba Shringara is shown. Here there is no Vipralamba Shringara. Vipralamba Shringara can arise only when the Nayaka has experienced that love and now she is away from him. Here Esha Api Tulya Ramana Abhavat. So she has never experienced it in the first place. So she will never know what it means to be without it. Right? Only if you have experienced something, only if you have gone in the car, the next day if you have to walk to school, then there is a problem. If you have not experienced it, you will never know the problem of that arises or the dukkha that arises out of absence. Right? So here you have to only describe the lavanyam of her. So atra tanmyaha iti padam kevala shabda anuprasa. Anuprasa is that type of shabdalankara where there is a repetition of the consonants and along with the vowel. So tan, ta, a and na, that entire combination is being repeated. Tanvyaha, tanum, tanvata. Only for that it is being used. Na kanchit artha auchityam, na kanchit artha auchitya chamatkara kanikam avishkaroti. That kanchit is an adjective to the kanika. So kanika is not even a little bit of chamatkara beauty in artha auchityam. Or appropriateness of the artha that is being used, that is Tanvi, the meaning of Tanvi is Krishangi. Does it even fit or is it even appropriate? There is not even a little bit of it that it creates. Okay, so Kanchit artha auchitya chamatkara kanikam na avishkaroti. Whenever you find a na, just go and connect it with the kriyapadam. It's easier. Unless it is saying ashwaha na, gajaha na, if it is a list like that, or if it is says so, most of the times it will go and connect with the verb. If you connect it with the verb, it's easier. It does not produce avishkaroti, not even an iota of artha uchityam in this point. There are so many other words that can be used. Anyaniva niratishaya rupa lavanya vyanjakani. There are so many other words, anyani bhavanti, anyani, rupa lavanya, niratishaya rupa lavanya. See here, why he introduces this sentence is, see, you might ask, sundaryaha ityatra padam anurupam syat. Instead of tanvyaha, you can use the word sundaryaha. Why don't you use sundaryas tanum tanvata? It would also work. But there is a problem there where if you look at it, sundaryaha, you have three vowels there. So which means there are three matras that you need to include, not three matra, it is three akshara, right? Guru and laghu. Then your meter will be a problem. You're looking at ko, arthas, chetasi, vedhasa, विनिहितः सेवेन् वाट् एवर् ट्वेल्व् नो तन्व्यास् तनुं तन्वत सो सेवेन् 12 and 7, so 19 letters should come there. Whereas if you include Sundaryaha, it is 3 letters instead of Tanvyaha, which is 2 letters. So there is a Chando Vichitti there. There is a problem with the Chandas or the meter. How do you come about? You can't just simply say Sundaryaha, let's replace Tanvyaha with Sundaryaha, then it will be a good shloka. No. There are, okay, Chando Vichitti, fine, I accept. But there are so many other words. Anyani Padani. Niratishaya Rupa Lavanya Vyanjakani. There are many other words that are suggestive of a beauty which is exceptional. You can use any number of those words. Look up the Amarakosham, don't ask me. That's what Kevendra is actually saying. You don't need to put in this word just because your concentration is only on Shabda Alankara and not the Artha or the beauty of the Shloka or the Rasam. Right? So it does not contribute. There is a problem there. One is talking about Vipralambashangara, the other is talking about the Lavanya Atishayam. And as a point of, she's good for Sambhoga Shangara. So the two of them cannot come together there and it clashes, creates a clash there. Okay. Next. Because he used that word Tanvyaha, where will that Pada Tanvi come and fit? This is not there in your material. This is there in the text. Since I'm looking at the entire text, I would like to take the shlokas that are there in the text also and explain beyond the material. Okay. So this is another example of Pada Auchityam. This is from Ratnavali. So before that, he has this line where he says, Tandi Padam Tu Viraha Vidhura Ramani Jane Prayuktam. Viraha Vidhura. Ramani Jane, Mahila Jane, those ladies who are Vidhura, Dukkhita, who are suffering because of Viraha, separation, it is used, Tanvi is the word used in for those people. Artha Auchitya Shobham Janeti, if you use it for a girl who is in Viraha, then it increases the Artha Auchitya. Yatha Shri Harshasya. In Shri Harsha, Ratnavali is suffering from, she likes the king a lot. She likes Udayana. She is Sagarika. Her other name is Sagarika. She is known as Sagarika until her real name Ratnavali is known. Okay. So Sagarika likes the king a lot. Because she is not able to meet him, she is behaving like a person in Viraha. Okay. Because of Viraha, the Manmatha, the Tapa, the heat that is there in her body has to be controlled. So the friend who is there with her has set up a bed for her to cool her body. So there are a lot of leaves and the Shayanam is made of Bisini Patram. Bisini Patram is lotus leaves. So lotus leaves which has been taken fresh from the Saras, that is the nearby lotus ponds, they use those leaves as a shayanam so that the body heat is dissipated. The king Udayana comes there, he looks at that shayanam. She is not there anymore, she has gone. So he looks at that shayanam and talks and says that this bed tells me that she is suffering too much from Manmatha Tapa, Manmatha Avastha. Parimlanam penis tana jagana sanghata. This Ratnavali has been written by Shri Harsha. From there it is. So Parimlanam penis tana jagana sanghat ubayataha tanor madhyasyantaha parimilanam aprapya haritam. It should be. Ila. It says parimalanam. No, there is something wrong here. 1 minute. Sorry. Milanam aprapya. So parimlanam penis tanajagana sangad upayataha tanor madhyasya antaha parimilanam aprapya haritam idam vyastanyasam slata bhuja latakshepa valanaihi krishangya santapam vadati visini patra shayanam. Krishangyaha santapam vadati visini patra shayanam. Visini patra shayanam. Bisini is, Bisa is lotus stalk. Bisini is that which has the lotus stalk is a lotus again. So Padma Patra Shayanam, a lotus leaf bed has been made for her, and that bed Krishangyaha Santapam Vadati, it speaks of the dukkha or the tapam, the body heat that the girl has been experiencing. The word Krishangi here is used very appropriately in the sense Krishani Angani Yasyahasa. She has very thin body structure because she is suffering and she is not able to eat, or she's because of that Manmatha tapa, she has become so thin. Now, what are all the things that the Shayanam is saying? Peenasthana jaghana sangat ubhayataha parimlanam. Ubhayataha, both sides. It is, so you imagine the shape of her body, where her hip and her breasts are quite heavy. So it has more contact with the Shayanam and the leaves. So the leaves have faded very quickly because of the heat and the contact. Her madhya is very tanu, that is her waist portion is very thin, so it does not have any contact with the shayanam and that patram, so it is haritam, and that portion is completely green. So peena stana, peena is prithu, great big stana, and jaghana, the hip portion, sangat, because of the association with these two parts of the body, ubayataha, on both sides, it is parimlanam. Mlayati means it's fading. The green leaves are all fading on both sides, but in the middle, tanoho madhyasya antaha parimilanam aprapya. Tanoho madhyasya, tanu is the body, and that body's middle portion, madhyasya, or you can say tanoho madhyasya, is because the middle portion is very tanu, thin, because it is small. With that portion, parimilanam aprapya, it does not get a contact with the middle portion, which is very thin. Atayeva antaha haritam. So the if a big leaf is placed on both sides, ubayataha parimlanam, it is faded, but the middle portion of that leaf is not faded because her waist comes at that portion, and parimilanam aprapya, it does not get a connection there. Then what happens? The sides and all are the entire shayanam. Idam shayanam katham asti lata akshepa shlatha buja lata akshepa valanaihi vyastanyastam. It is not arranged properly. If nobody has slept on that bed will be made neat and clean. Right? But here, vyastanyasam, it is not arranged neatly. It is as if someone has so shlatha buja, you turn and toss and turn. Her shlatha buja, her arms are all have been turning and tossing this way and that way. She puts her arms this way and that way. Shlatha buja lata, her creeper like arms, which are shlatha, which are very weary and tired, she keeps moving it this way and that way. Akshepa valanaihi, because of the movement of throwing her arms, creeper like arms, this way and that way. Idam visini patra shayanam vyastanyasam. It has been rearranged. It's not arranged in a proper manner. Krishangyaha santapam vadati. So it speaks about the santapa that she has been experiencing. Atra sagarikayaha virahavastha suchakam, it indicates her virahavastha, that love in separation. Krishangyaha iti padam paramauchityam pushnati. It's a very, very appropriate word to be used. Here he cannot use sundaryaha santapam. That would not fit here. Right? Atha sundaryas santapam vadati visini patrashayanam. It won't work here. Right? So because that is not auchityam, it does not clearly portray, he is not talking about her beauty, but he is talking about her virahavastha. Whereas the earlier shloka was that lavanya dravina vyayaha and all that, we are only surprised about how Brahma can even create such a beautiful form. When we are talking about that, you can't talk about how she is in virahavastha. Okay. Next. Now we go to Vakya Auchityam. Vakyagatam Auchityam Darshayitumaha. Auchitya Rachitam Vakyam Satatam Satam Sammatam. Always Satatam Satam Sammatam, great people will accept a Vakya. A sentence which is created, rachitam, auchitya rachitam, which is created with auchityam, with a propriety. That is, if it is created in a proper manner, people will accept it. How? He gives two upama here. Tyagodagram iva aishwaryam, shilojjwalam iva shrutam. Someone who has a lot of wealth, but he is just hoarding wealth, then it is not accepted by people, by good people. Satam sammatam na bhavati. Well, many people might say, see, he has a lot of wealth. But if it is along with, associated with the tyaga udagram unnata tyagena sahitam aishwaryameva shobhate. It's like karna. Dana, you have to give more of danam, even if as you have aishwaryam. Only if you give it in charity will it be acceptable to many great people. If you don't give charity, it is of no use to anybody. You're only hoarding that wealth. The same way, someone who has read so much, shrutam, learning is more beautiful and it is more acceptable only if that person, shila ujjwalam, if he glows with the character, if he shines with character. If he doesn't have a good character, there is no use for the learning that he has. Nobody is going to want to learn from that person. You should show a great strength of character, a nice character also, in the sense you have to give, impart that knowledge to people. And imparting that knowledge will also come only if you have that superior character in you. So, shilam ujjwalam shrutam iva, tyaga udagram udagram udattam, great charity. Udagram Aishwaryam Iva, Auchitya Rachitam Vakyam, a Vakya with the Auchityam is acceptable by great people. Again, the vritti that's given there is Auchitya Rachitam Vakyam, that Satam is not just Satpurushaha iti Satam. It's not only good people here. We don't want a character certificate here. When we are talking about Alankara Shastra, we need Kavya Viveka Vichakshananama Vivatam. Those who are Vichakshana, experts in Viveka, analysis of Kavya. For them, Auchitya Rachitam Vakyam Abhimatam Bhavati. It's not, I am a very good person, but you don't know anything about Kavyam, there is no use. I'm not talking about those people. Next. Now, Udaharanam for Vakya Auchityam. What is the Udaharanam he gives? Yatha mama Vinayavalyam. Vinayavalli is a work by Kshemendra. And there, this is a two shloka, which is Yugmakam, where the idea of the shloka completes only after the two shlokas are done. So, Devo Dayavan Vijayi Jitatma Yamo Manas Samyama Mananiyo Iti Bruvana Swabhujam Pramashti Yah Kichaka Kalika Kaladandam Dhirasakirmira Jatasurarihi Kubera Shaurya Prashamopadishta Drishto Hidimba Dayitakurunam Paryanta Rekha Gananakritantaha. I really enjoyed this shloka when I was reading. Devo Dayavan. See, the scene is Bhima is talking about his prowess, his parakrama, without talking about his parakrama. That's the beauty of the shloka. He says, Devaha Dayavan. And he talks about the good qualities of the other brothers also, the siblings. Devo Dayavan. Yudhishthira Devaha, Jeshtha Bhrata. So he gives an honor to him. So Devaha Yudhishthira Dayavan. Extremely daya, he has a kindness towards people. It's actually a way to say, see, he's too kind to be fighting in the war. So that is the idea here. Why does Bhima talk about that? Devo Dayavan. Next, Vijayi Jitatma. Vijayi is Arjuna. Arjuna has, Jita Atma. He is Atma is here, is Manas. He has won over his manas, manah prakrahamayava cha, na indriyani hayanahu manah prakrahamayava cha. Manas is like the reins for the five indriya, which are like horses, which are running amok in all directions. Indriyas have no control, and it is the manas that controls. And Arjuna has won over that manas, jitatma, vijayi jitatma. Otherwise, for the in the entire war, and when both sides are standing there, why should Arjuna get that question? Can I fight my elders? And he is the one who asks Krishna at that point of time. So Vijayi, Arjuna, is Jitatma. Yamautu manasamyama mananiyo. They are already manasamyama. They have, it is not Jita Atma. They have controlled their mind and they are honored for that. Mananiyo. Manasamyame samyamau iti karanat mananiyo bahumanya. They are honorable and they are being honored everywhere, and they are known, famous to have controlled their mind. So all of them are useless when there is a war. So who is saying this? Bhima. Not just, you know, Sadharana Bhima. The adjectives that he gives for Bhima, iti bruvanaha, as he is saying this, who is saying this? Yaha, he who, you know, kichaka akalika kala dandam swabhujam pramarshti. The person who is saying this, actually he keeps on touching his bhuja, you know, his shoulder. He is saying kichaka akalika kaladandaha. Kaladanda is the yama's weapon, right? This bhuja, his arm is like yama's weapon. It's like an inopportune weapon, untimely weapon which went and destroyed kichaka. It's like the untimely Kaladanda which destroyed Kichaka. Kichaka was not supposed to die at all at that point of time, maybe. Or you can say it is an unexpected, it proved to be the unexpected weapon that killed Kichaka. Tathavidam swabhujam pramarshti. Pramarshti means he just, tadavi kudukarudu. He caresses his bhuja. Adi, iti bruvanaha. Who is doing this? Saha drishtaha. Iti bruvanaha saha, the one who was saying thus was seen. Saha drishtaha, saha bhimaha drishtaha. The word bhima is not mentioned here. Who was seen there? Dhiraha. Strong, very brave person. Kirmira jata asura arihi. Kirmira jata asuraha. There is an asura by name Kirmira. And Kirmira also means vichitra jata. He had a different type of hair, it seems. So his name itself was Kirmira. He is the brother of Hidimba, one of the brothers of Hidimba. Hidimba had two, three brothers. One is Bakasura, the other is Hidimba, and the third one is Kirmira. We don't know how many more. Actually, Kirmira Vadha is a very famous Kathakali Kudiyattam thing in Malayalam, Kerala. Kirmira Vadham, they take up Kirmira Vadha as a big project and do it. Kirmira Jatasura Arihi, the enemy of the Rakshasa by name Kirmira. Next is Kuvera Shaurya Prashama Upadeshta. How was this? This is actually, it's a very interesting story. How many Purana stories he knows, I'm amazed by that. Kshemendra. Kubera had that huge garden, right, and where the Saugandhika flowers were, and Bhima went in search of those Saugandhika flowers for Draupadi, because she smelt it and then said, I want those flowers, and he went to that Saugandhika area, and he killed where that flowers were there, and he killed Kubera's army. Kubera's friend or one other yaksha is, I don't know his name. Both of them were once traveling, and I think the other person, Kubera's friend, spit on Agastya, and Agastya put a curse on Kubera, saying the person who did this will be killed. He, along with his entire army, will be killed. It's because of that army and because of the presence of that friend that you are so arrogant. Kubera did not come and apologize to him. And then he comes and apologizes at that point of time. I think Agastya says, someone will come and the one who enters your Gandharva Udyana you know, kill all of them, and then you're sharper, you will get sharper vimochana. So that is the story that he indicates here, where Kubera Shaurya Prashama Upadeshta. He became the person who was responsible, Upadeshta. He is a more responsible for controlling Prashama, the Shaurya of Kubera, for the Parakrama of Kubera. Kubera's Shaurya lay in his entire Yaksha army, and he was responsible for controlling that army or destroying that army. Prashama is actually Nasha. So Kubera Shaurya Prashama Upadeshta. Next is Paryanta Rekha, Kurunam Paryanta Rekha Ganana Kritantaha. Kurunam, for the Kuru Vamsha, the people who are all in the Kuru Vamsha, you have hundreds of people there, and for all of them, he was like the Paryanta Rekha, like a boundary Ganana Kritantaha. Now the list of Kauravas are there. Those men are all standing in one line. And there is Yama who is letting them into their either the Swarga or the Naraka. Bhima is like the person who is standing there and killed each and every one of them and sent them. So he is very much the Yama who is standing at the Rekha, Paryanta Rekha, and doing the counting of how many Kauravas have died and how many of them are there. So why he is giving so many adjectives, it all is an adding to the greatness and the parakrama. It shows the veera rasam of Bhima here, right? So something else, if you Hidimba Daitaha. In case you feel that, you know, there is too much of Veera Rasam here, maybe let me introduce some Hidimba Daita. But even that, he didn't say Draupadi Daitaha. He said Hidimba Daitaha. She is a Rakshasi. And the process with which he attained Hidimba was also through showing his prowess. He had to kill Hidimbasura and then he married Hidimba. Right? They were all that the four people whom he killed were Kichaka, Bakasura, Hidimba, the Hidimba, and Kirmira. He also controlled Kubera. And the Kuru Vamsha, the entire set of race of Kuru was killed by him also. All the 100 sons were killed by him. So by highlighting all of these adjectives for Bhima, he is showing the rasam that is there here. Atra Bhimasya Bhimacharita Uchita, those things that are appropriate to his charitam. He could have talked about how, you know, Hanuman won over Bhima, but he did not say that. Then there you will talk about Bhima's parajaya and not Bhima's jaya. You know, where he goes for the Saugandhika flower. And that episode he highlights by saying Kubera Shaurya Prashama Upadeshta, and not by pointing out that he went to find the flowers for Draupadi. Then there is a lalitya, there is an anauchityam there. Here, this Kubera Shaurya mention is better, right? Instead of you know, winning over all of these people in that Saugandhika place, he found an old monkey and he tried to lift that monkey's tail and he could not do it. All those is showing Hanuman's greatness and he didn't mention that. So he only takes those incidents in Bhimacharita Uchita, those appropriate incidents in Bhima's life, which is Kichaka Akalika Kaladanda, Hidimba Daita, Adibihi Padaihi. What does he say? Unnidra Raudra Swarupa Anurupaha. It's either Veera Swarupa Anurupaha or Raudra Swarupa Anurupaha. Raudra is better. Maybe it depends on the context in which he brings this. That's why if we don't have the entire text in our mind, we cannot fix the rasam in this. Because the poet himself, Kshemendra himself, says it is Unnidra Raudra Swarupa Anurupaha, we can safely assume that he is talking about the Raudra Rasam. And any other adjectives would have been a pratibandhaka for that Raudra Rasa. Whereas these Uchita Padaha, Padani, Raudra Rasam, Rasasya Utkarsham Nayanti. So, Unnidra Raudra Rasa Swarupa Anurupaha, it is very conducive to the Raudra Rasa Vakyartaha. Because of that, this Vakyartha is Sajivaha Iva Bhasate. It's as if it is brought to life. We can imagine in front of us the way Bhima is, you know, slowly he's just caressing his arms and he is saying this. Yudhishthira Devo Dayavan Vijayi Jitatma Yama Manas Samyama Mananiya Iti Bruvanaha Swabhujam Pramashti. I like that word. Swabhujam Pramashti. And how is that Bhuja? Yah Kichaka Akalika Kala Dandam Dhiras Sakirmira Jatasurarihi Kubera Shaurya Prashamopadishta Drishto Hidimbadaita Kurunam Paryantarekha Ganana Kritantaha. Beautiful shloka. Do we have time for one more? Okay. Now, this another shlokam, again, I don't think it is there in the text for you. Athava Rajashekarasya. In the earlier one, he said Rajashekara did not put any proper word, right? So he pointed out for Pada Anauchityam. Now he takes Rajashekara for the Vakya Auchityam. We saw Raudra Rasam in the earlier shloka. The same Auchityam can also be used for Shrungara Rasa Pratito. So the shloka here is Sambandhi Purubhu Bujam Manasija Vyaparadiksha Guru Gaurangi Vadanopama Parichita Parichitaha Taravadhu Vallabaha Sadhyo Marjita Dakshinatya Taruni Dantavadata Dyutihi Chandra Sundari Drishyatam Ayamitaha Chandisha Chudamanihi. I don't know how he takes the shloka. There is actually a, I don't know, maybe Pada Anauchityam or what, I'm not sure. Let's see. Okay. Sambandhi Puru Bhubujam. Now, Sundari, hey Sundari, if you look at the, where is that? In the last line, you'll find Sundari Chandraha Drishyatam Itaha. I am Chandraha. Let me show you the Chandra. It's so beautiful. Itaha Drishyatam. Look at him from this side. You know, Purvasyam Dishi. Chandrodayaha Bhavati. And he's showing her, I am Itaha Chandraha Drishyatam. Now, how is the Chandra? Everything else is in Pratama Vibhakti as an adjective for the Chandra. Puru Bhubujam Sambandhi. Puru Vamsha Ragnyam Bhubuk is Raja. So, Puru Vamsha Ragnyam Sambandhi Yeshaha. Katham Sambandhi? Chandrasya Sutaha Budhaha, Budhasya Sutaha Pururavaha, Yesya Vamshaha. So, Pururava was born to Buddha, who is Chandra's son, and from him only all the entire race, Vamsha of Puru Vamsha came about. So, Puru Bhubujam for the, he is the relative of Puru Bhubujam for the Puru Rajas. Is this important? Yes. Why? Because if you, for that you'll have to go to Vikram Urvashiyam, Kalidasa's Nataka, where the main character is Pururavas, and his he likes Urvashi, and how he was much in love with her. Because it is a Shringara Rasa that he wants to show here, everything adds to that Uddipanam. Manmatha Uddipanam. It kindles the love sentiment by giving all these adjectives for Chandra. Just like how Pururavas was in love with Urvashi, I'm also in love with you. Or this person will kindle that love in you and me. So look at that Chandra. Next, Manasija Vyapara Diksha Guru. It teaches the sentiment of love. Manasija Vyapara, the different aspects of Manasija, Manmatha, Manmatha's work, it is like the preceptor, Diksha Guru, now like Mantropadesham, it gives us the mantram of the Manmatha Vyapara. That is Chandra. Chandra is the Uddipana Vibhavam. The moment you see the Chandra, you have your Manav Prasadaha Bhavati. It becomes clear, you think of nice things. It is also equated to Gaurangi Vadana Upama Parichitaha. Parichitaha, it has a fame. It is very popular. As an upama, as a standard of comparison for a ladies, a beautiful ladies, Gaurangani Vadana, Vadana, Upama, Vadanena Upamiyate Chandraha. So Gaurangi, a fair woman's face is being compared to this Chandra. Tara Vadhu Vallabhaha. Not only that, he is the Vallabha, Priya of Tara Vadhu, his wife's Tara. There are 27 Tara who are all his wives. He is also a Priya. He is liked by all of his wives. Sadyo Marjita Dakshinatya Taruni Dantavadata Dyutihi. Dakshinatya Taruni, southern ladies, they are all brushing their teeth, and the moment they brush their teeth, the white kanti, the white prakasha that comes out of their teeth, Chandra looks like that, it seems. Sadyo Marjita, immediately brushed teeth, of whom Dakshinatya Taruni Danta Avadata. Avadata is white or clear. The clear dyuti prakasha of Danta, the teeth of Dakshinatya Taruni, the southern women who have just brushed their teeth. Sadyo Marjita. Why does he say this? I was just thinking, why is this included here? You know, what is the beauty and the auchityam with a well-brushed teeth? Maybe it looks beautiful. Nobody wants to, you know, talk to a girl who has not brushed her teeth or what. I don't know. I'm trying to think. It's more, you know.
Dakshinatya Taruni, I mean, it's... going back to that, and the Tilakam and Chandanam or Shlokam Potanare. Dakshinathyana Innukonyo, less fair skin, Nana Pallu Nunana Tirima.
Yes,
I think.
Maybe that's what he is trying to say. Illa Gaurangi, Vadana, Upama, Parichitahana, Mela Solito. That is like for people who are more in the north are more fair than the people who are in the south, maybe. I don't know. Let's try to say it like that. Then the one with a darker complexion, the shine that comes from the teeth will be more prominent. Maybe. Correct. More than that, I think, I feel what is more conducive to the Shringara Rasam is what I am thinking. Maybe the Chumbanartham, it will be easier, no? That is what I was looking at. Because it is the Shringara Rasa Uddeepanaya, then it makes more sense in Gartika Solra. Not just the Prakasham. So Chandraha Drishyatam. Who is this Chandra? He is not only Shringara Uddeepakaha, and he is even worn by Chandisha Chudamani. Chandi is Parvati. Parvati is Isha, is Shiva. He is not only Uddipana for all the Manmatha Ananga Uddipana, but he is also Chandisha's Chudamani, Shiva's Chudamani, like a crest jewel for Shiva. That is the only problem I have. Why to use Chandisha? You can use Gaurisha Chudamani, may have been more appropriate, I feel. To give that beauty to her, no, instead of Chandi, Chandi gives more of a kopam. The idea is the Nayaka has a kopam and he wants her to let go of her anger and look at the Chandra so that her mind is changed. The Chandra might be Chandisha Chudamani, but you look at the Chandra, it has so many other beautiful qualities. So let go of your anger and look at it. We don't know the context, so we have to try to.
So, Alikada Sirin is already.
So smile like how the southern ladies are all smiling. It could be a reason, you know, these are all the vyangya that you can get if you understand the context more. Illana Chandishangaradu mathram konja neradradu. I didn't feel that it fit properly there.
So is this shloka considered for the Vakya Auchityam or Anauchityam?
It is considered for Vakya Auchityam only. I am like only talking about that padam which is not fitting my okay. So it is Vakya Auchityam. Why? Because if you read the Vritti, you will understand. So Atrapi, just like in the earlier shloka where Bhima had so many Bhima Charita Uchita padam which gave rise to Raudra Rasam, here Chandramasaha शृङ्गार अन्तरङ्गैः अनङ्ग उद्दीपनैः पदैः. सो शृङ्गार अन्तरङ्गैः, दोस् विच् आर् वेरि वैटल् फार् द शृङ्गार रस एण्ड् विच् उद्दीपन किण्डल्स् द अनङ्ग आर् द मन्मथ द ऐडिया आफ् लव् सेण्टिमेण्ट् दोस् पद दोस् वर्ड्स् आर् बीङ्ग् यूस्ड् फार् चन्द्र. Hence, the Vakyartha, the entire Vakyartha has a great propriety that way. It is for Vakya Auchityam. Because he showed Raudra Rasam, he, as a contrast, he is also saying this Vakya Auchityam can exist in other rasas also. Okay?
Yeah, but that Southern lady thing, how is that
adding? Yeah, we were trying to fit it, no?
I was thinking, He quoted this as an anauchityam, again bringing Rajashekara into the anauchitya category.
No, but poor fellow, he is actually quoting him for Vakya Auchityam. But here what it is see the southern ladies, that's what Kamakshi and I were saying, in the sense, when you look at Chandisha Chudamani and the Dakshinatya Taruni Danta Avadata Dyutihi, both are actually saying, one is saying it is the Kopa Devata, Shiva's crest jewel, but at the same time, the Chandra also has the Prakasha of a lady who is smiling, who has just brushed her teeth, and she is smiling, the Kanti that comes out of her teeth is very beautiful. So, for a Nayika who is angry, and the Nayika is trying to placate her, you will say, look at the Chandra, you have to smile like that. You know, after looking at the Chandra, let go of your anger and smile. Maybe he's trying to give that vyangyam here through the shloka.
Okay.
That's the only way I can see, you know, to explain it.
Yeah.
Okay. So, atrapi chandramasaha shringara antarangaihi अनङ्ग उद्दीपनैः पदैः निर्वर्तितः वाक्यार्थः सर्वार्थ औचित्य सामर्थ्येन. बिकॉज ऑल द वर्ड्स हैव एन औचित्य आर प्लेस्ड इन सच अ मैनर दैट इट इज प्रॉपर एंड इट फिट्स द मीनिंग ऑफ द एंटायर सेंटेंस. समुचितार्थवशेन अत्यर्थम, समुचितार्थवशेन मीन्स टुगेदर, not just each one separately. What is the difference between pada auchityam and vakya auchityam? Pada auchityam is just one word that is either a problem or the pada anauchityam, and one word lends like a huge beauty to the shlokam, entire shloka itself. Without that one word, then you have a problem. Without that mugdha, if we had had Tanvi there or Gauri something, then it would not fit. Nari, that would not fit there, right? The meaning will not be understood properly also. Whereas here, each and every word contributes to the samuchita artha vashena, because it is combined together, and the artha and because of that combined meaning, atyartham arthaniyatam praptaha. Arthaniyata means acceptable. It becomes extremely and completely acceptable. Atyartham, atyantam, cha, arthaniyatam, praptaha. It becomes completely and atyantam is extremely. Atyartham means completely. In all sense, it becomes arthaniyata, acceptable, or meaningful. Right? Not even because he says this, I am trying to explain the words Chandisha and Danta Davanam. Otherwise, I won't put so much of effort in that. Next is Vakya Gata Anauchityam. Maybe we will do that next class. Okay? We'll do it tomorrow. Any other doubt? No, right? Mm-hmm.